On June 10, 2025, OpenAI had a massive server outage. In addition to Zora and the ChatGPT API, the web and mobile versions of ChatGPT were also affected. I was on the go that day and wanted to finish a YouTube script on my notebook, as usual with the support of ChatGPT. But it didn't work, and the next day I wanted to record. That's when I first realized how dependent I already am on Cloud AI, like so many others, maybe you too. And it doesn't even have to be a server outage. A trip by plane, even a train ride with a bad internet connection, is already enough to not be able to work with AI support as usual. This constant dependence on cloud services and internet connectivity creates a real problem for anyone who needs reliable AI assistance. Whether you're traveling, dealing with poor connectivity, or facing unexpected outages, being cut off from AI tools can significantly impact your productivity. There must be a solution for that, right? There is, but it's a bit different than you might think. There's already been a lot said about local AIs, meaning AIs that you run directly on your own computer, but usually with enormous hardware requirements. There are hardly any notebooks that meet the huge demand for RAM and GPU power. And let's be honest, none of us wants to lug around a 3 kg gaming notebook all the time. That's why the solution I found for myself, and with which I'm no longer afraid of trips or server outages, is much simpler and lighter. Small language models, or SLMs for short, are extra small open source AI models that can be installed on standard notebooks and even on phones and tablets. And they can take over a whole range of tasks for which we would otherwise use ChatGPT and company. I'm going to introduce you to 3 of these models, which tasks they can handle for you, how little hardware they require, and what kind of speed you can expect. Of course, in addition to the independence from cloud and internet, you also get the advantage that all local models have. Your data stays on your device and remains private. But what does this mean for your actual workflow? Let me show you how these models fit into real creative projects and daily challenges. First up is Tiny Llama, 637 MB in size. Yes, just 0.6 GB. It basically runs on any hardware and, like all the models I'm showing you, works just with the CPU. It's the smallest model I could find that still delivers usable results despite its size. For example, Tiny Llama generates text at around 35 tokens per second on my old laptop, faster than I can read. When it comes to writing, it's like your creative partner, giving you ideas when you're stuck. But what if you want more than speed? That's where Gemma 3 comes in. The version I use is only a little bigger than Tiny Llama at 0.8 GB, but almost as fast and can do quite a bit more. When I work on text, it's my model of choice. Rewriting, summarizing, even translations are no problem despite the compact size, though the translations typically require some editing for fluency and accuracy. By the way, I also have this version of Gemma 3 on my iPhone and my iPad as fallback. Interestingly, modern phones and tablets often have highly optimized chips and faster RAM, which means Gemma 3 can run even faster there than on some laptops. What these two models aren't so good at is logic, mathematics, and reasoning. This is where many users hit a wall with smaller models, and if your work depends on serious problem solving, here's the model I rely on for logic-heavy tasks. Phi4 Mini Reasoning. At 2.5 GB in size and with 3.8 billion parameters, it's significantly larger than the first two models, but compared to local 7TB models and especially the proprietary cloud AIs, it's still downright tiny. That's why it's still fast enough for most notebooks and mobile phones. Need support with a problem? Microsoft's recent demonstrations, which I'll link in the description, show that their Phi4 models punch far above their weight class. On reasoning benchmarks like GSM 8K and MES, which test mathematical and logical problem-solving skills, these smaller models match or exceed the performance of models several times their size. An important additional benefit, Phi4 has a context window of 128K, which means you can use very long prompts and texts. perfect for analyzing entire documents or maintaining extended conversations. TinyLlama, rapid brainstorming. Gemma 3, refining text drafts. Phi4, solving technical problems in code reviews and handling complex math and logic challenges. For me, the peace of mind knowing my tools are always ready matters more than just specs or speed. If you found this useful, hit the like button. It really helps others discover these tools. And subscribe if you want more practical AI content like this. What would you use an SLM for? Maybe you already have one for purposes I haven't even considered here. Feel free to write in the comments. In short, small models, big impact wherever you work. Stay curious and see you in the next part.